Good morning, children. How are you?
Yes, you are fine and you are safe, right?
So, for the class 4 children, yesterday we have completed these all terrestrial plants, right?
Yes.
Now, we are going to read the textbook, textual reading of aquatic plants. Okay, children? Plants that grow in water are called aquatic plants. Plants that grow in water are called aquatic plants. Okay. What are aquatic plants, children? The plants which grow in water are called as aquatic plants. Among them means in all of them, some float on water. So what the some aquatic plants, they float on water, while others grow completely underwater. But few of them are growing on water, but few of them, they are completely growing under the water. Okay, children. Next, aquatic plants are of three types. What are they? Let us see. Floating plants, fixed plants, and underwater plants. They have given figures 2.4, 2.5, and 2.6. Let us see. Yes. These are the floating plants, duckweed and water hyacinth. This is 2.4 figure. Next, 2.5, let us see. That is a lotus flower. That is a fixed plant, right? And next one is the hydrilla. Hydrilla is totally underwater plants. Yes, that you can see in an aquarium. Okay, children? Yes. These plants float because they are either light or small in size. Duckweed, water lettuce, and water hyacinth are some such plants. These plants protect small water animals from the heat of the sun. See here, children, these are the floating plants. Okay, what are the examples for floating plants, children? Duckweed, water lettuce, and water hyacinth. And what these plants are doing, children? They are protecting the small animals like insects, okay, which are floating in the water, and so they are protecting the heat from the, which is directly getting from the sun, okay. If you can see, they are floating on the water. Inside this, you can find a small insects or small animals are there, and they are just taking the protection from the sun. Okay, so when they are on the lands, when the plants are grows on the land, that all the animals and we human beings take shelter and protection, okay, from the plants. But in the water, they are very small insects, my children. That is the reason they only protect the small insects, small fishes or tadpoles which are swimming in the water, right? So that they can protect. Okay, children. This is a plant of water hyacinth, and this is the duckweed. Okay, you can see the duckweed is near to the Husain Sagar, right? Yes, most of the ponds and river ponds, they are present in them. Okay, yes, so these are the floating plants. Okay, children, next one, fixed plants. Let us see about the fixed plants. Some plants are fixed to the bed of the pond. Yes, some plants are fixed to the bed of the plants. They are sticking to that mud. They are sticking to that pond. Okay. You must have seen plants like the lotus and water lily. The stem of the lotus is hollow and light, which keeps the leaves and the flowers afloat. So, if you find the lotus, the petals as well as the leaves and the even the stem, it is hollow in nature, and these petals and the leaves also very light in weight. Okay, so that's the reason they can float in the water. Okay, this is also used to make tasty dishes, right? Yes, most of them are preparing from the flowers and petals different dishes. Okay, the leaves are broad and have stomata only the upper side. These broad floating leaves provide a nesting place for some tiny birds. See, children, in the What is the speciality for the lotus children? See, upside, if you see this upside, only stomata is present, okay? And the downside, they are protecting the small insects. And you, if you observe the leaves of the lotus, you can find that most of the birds are preparing, small birds are preparing the nest on them and they are taking the shelter on it, okay? So plants are every time useful as children, okay? Whether they are in the water, whether they are on the land, whether they are in the hilly places also, okay? So all the animals are depending upon the plants. It's either it's for shelter, either it's for food, okay children? That is the reason we have to grow more plants, okay children? Yes. Next aquatic plant is underwater plants. Plants like hydrilla, tape grass, and pondweed remain underwater. These plants have long ribbon-like narrow leaves. These leaves arise in clusters from the roots and have no stomata at all. Okay, if you see what are the examples for the underwater plants children, they are hydrilla, tape grass, and pondweed. Okay. And they have a ribbon-like narrow structures. If you see the hydrilla, see how they are ribbon-like structures and they have no stomata on their surface because they are totally submerged in the water, right? Then how, yes, they are preparing their food and that is the reason they can give out the oxygen and the carbon dioxide. And because of that, the animals which are living in the water, they can survive more longer. These leaves arise in clusters. If you are seeing the clusters also, like they are in more number. If the leaves are thin, they are in more number, in the clusters, in the groups, okay. They breathe through their body surface, okay. So they breathe through the body surface. If suppose this is a plant is there, they can, the surface is present here. Then they can surface, from the body surface only they can breathe, okay. So they don't have any stomata, okay. These plants clean the water by removing the carbon dioxide breathed out by aquatic animals like fish and turtles. This is why we put such plants in aquariums. So, what they are doing? They are doing what? Giving out oxygen and they are absorbing the carbon dioxide in the water. And this is the reason why such plants are keeping in the aquariums. See, for the aquariums or all these, if you see this one, all plants are submerged in water where the fishes can live long, okay? And they are very helpful in the small insects also. And they don't have stomata and they can, most of the plants, they can remove the carbon dioxide, right? Why they can remove the carbon dioxide? Because if they absorb the carbon dioxide, then they can prepare their own food, okay? So, this is all for the aquatic plants, children. Let us do this checkpoint also. Circle the correct answers. Cactus is a desert floating underwater plant. Yes, it is a desert plant. Okay, just circle it. In marshy desert hilly areas, the soil is clay and sticky. That is marshy areas. Okay. Duckweed and water lettuce are floating plants. They are floating plants. We have learned till now only, na, children. So, we are going to be continue the next one, this one. But till here, you have to complete it. Okay, children, please do this in your textbook, children. I hope you can do everything and just take care of yourself, children. Bye-bye, children.